Bitty Boo Brown.
You want to say hello to everybody? Y'all thought I was bullshit, didn't you? You thought I was just in the woods somewhere talking about being in Oklahoma. No, ma'am. There's Bitty.
And Camomeleon.
It's your boo. Camomeleon.
In the same place. At the same damn time. Thanksgiving, baby. Going to be classic. Y'all see it? D1. So, we made it through security. Security was a whole lot more or less stringent as I thought it was going to be. But we're here. I got about a 2-hour wait till the flight actually takes off. But that's right, man. Head to Tulsa. It's the closest place to Bitty Boo Brown. A.K.A. Bitty Boo, A.K.A. Bitty, A.K.A. Yeah, I know she got a lot of A.K.A.s. Dana. All right, guys. See y'all in a little bit, man. We almost there. Well, good morning, y'all. It's your boy Camo, man. There's my boy Blue. There's my other boy Copper. So it's the day after Thanksgiving, so I'm sorry, I don't have any footage of Thanksgiving. I think Bitty Boo Brown, a.k.a. Bitty Boo, a.k.a. Bitty, a.k.a. Yeah, I know she got a lot of a.k.a. Dana might have some footage from Thanksgiving, but I think most of it has just been, you know, just kind of enjoying ourselves. So this is it, guys. I've always liked this. I've always liked the peacefulness, the quietness, just the beauty, you know? But it's nice out here, man. It's really nice. It's real pretty. And out in the middle of nowhere, kind of where your boy Campbell likes it. Y'all know how I do it on the trail, man. Out in the middle of nowhere. Yeah. So, not sure what the day involves. You know, just gonna enjoy ourselves. Like I said, the fact that I'm here is already 100% satisfaction. Anything else is a bonus. But we had a great Thanksgiving yesterday, and met a lot of really, really nice people that I didn't even know existed anymore. And when I say that, I mean just people who are genuinely happy to see you and they never met you before. That doesn't happen very often. So, yeah, I'm not on the trail, guys. My own kind of adventure, if you will, you know, visiting those that love your boy Camo Can. And don't get it twisted, I hear y'all out there sucking your teeth, rolling your damn eyes, well, why don't he come visit us? We love Camo too. Excuse me, what's wrong with your damn pa? What's wrong with your wallet? Why you can't come see your boy Camo? Oh, ain't got nothing to say now, do we? Uh-huh, that's what I thought. That's okay, I still love y'all. Yeah, guys, so that's it, man. I just want to give y'all a quick update, man. Enjoying this beautiful 35-degree weather out here in Scipio, Oklahoma. Bitty Boo Brown. Camomeleon. Same place, same time. If I can get Bitty Boo Brown next shot. See y'all.
My love was an addiction when we came. Our love is strong when you go. You're gone forever. You string along.
guys. This is Turk Turk. And listen to why they call him Turk Turk. Says his name, Turk 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 Turk. At least that's... He's a turkey. Yes, he has a name. He's a big sucker too when he's up and walking around. I might not be able to see her. Yes. You want to say hello to everybody?
Hiya.
Y'all thought I was bullshit, didn't you? You thought I was just in the woods somewhere talking about being in Oklahoma. No, ma'am. There's Biddy. There's me. These ain't no camera tricks. And just in case, y'all see us. How you doing this morning?
I'm doing great.
Oh, I was telling everybody that I didn't get much footage yesterday because I was just enjoying the fact that I was here for Thanksgiving.
Well, I got a little bit, but I didn't get a whole lot. I just got, like, everybody saying Happy Thanksgiving, and the rest of it was just enjoying everyone. So,
yep.
They're just going to have to forgive me.
That's it. Y'all will be okay. I promise y'all will be okay. All right, we'll talk to y'all later. All right, guys. Y'all didn't actually think I was gonna come all the way down to Oklahoma and not go geocaching. You thought I was gonna go by myself?
No.
Yeah, I drugged them along too. Yeah. Yeah. Say hey. All right. So we came out here to our first geocache, and I'm gonna let Kate show us where it's at. Oh my goodness, look at that! Isn't that awesome? What was the clue, Kate?
It's not on the ground.
And I would be pretty... That's about right, though, isn't it? All right. Just wanted to show y'all that. We'll come back and show y'all what's inside later. Hold on. All right, guys. So we found our first geocache. And I'm going to let Biddy explain to everybody exactly what we just saw.
All right. We found the instructions explaining that it is a game to warn people that it ain't a bomb or anything. We've all wrote our names down on the log. We will be... folding it back up and putting it back in the cache and see who else comes along and finds it.
Jeep girl, Jeep, everybody else out there, smell of roses, everybody else that started geocaching because of me and Jeep and everybody, y'all looking at a lady that just found her first geocache.
And me.
And you, and Dakota. Now, we're not going to tell you what the name of this geocache is because we've already showed you the location. So that would just be wrong for us to give you all the information and you walk right up to it. But we found it, and that was fun. So to start, I might show y'all guys that. Yep. I'm coming down here to Oklahoma tainting everybody.
With
all this geocaching garbage. Huh?
Can we find another?
We will go see if we can find the other one.
Yay!
All right. Looks like we're going to go do another one. See y'all in a bit. And look who found his second cache ever. Was that not fun? Look, he went right to it. He's a natural. All right, guys. My battery's kind of low, so we're going to sign this log and put it back, and I think that's our extent of geocaching today. So,
found it. So
what do y'all think of geocaching? Cool? Y'all like it? Kate is ready to go on a month-long geocaching trip now.
Another.
Alright guys, we'll see y'all later. Alright, Biddy. You want to tell everybody what you're doing?
I'm making mashed taters.
Mashed taters? And what else? Watch out, y'all.
Venison.
Otherwise known as deer meat.
Oh my goodness. Mm-mm-mm. Don't y'all wish I would have came to Oklahoma Whippy? She could bought a ticket. Too late now. Oh, excuse me, Harley. Jeep girl, what I'm going to do is I'm gonna eat this, I'm gonna savor the taste, and the next time I see you, I'm gonna tell you about it. Sound like what you did with them cookies, ain't it? Mm-hmm. Thought so. Oh, it's a lot of food you're cooking, Biddy.
Like you're cooking. Got a lot of family.
Got a lot of family here today. She got her apron on. She
yes.
cooking deer. You see that, y'all? She's using it. What was the lady's name that bought you the, got you this? Forgive her.
Maddie
Snuggles. That's it.
Yes.
Yes. So Maddie, you see she's using it.
And oh, we'll be having gravy here in a little bit too.
Gravy.
Said no.
Gravy.
Gravy.
Taters.
Taters and
deer
gravy
meat.
And deer meat and beans and cornbread.
It's like she's cooking because somebody here's special. Oh wait, there is somebody here special. All right, guys. See y'all later. She's trying to coax the chickens into the cage and feed them at the same time. As you can see, it's working. Morning, guys. Oh, y'all not used to that. So let me give it to you the right way. It's your boy, Camomeleon. Day 3, guys. Biddy Boo Homestead. Y'all seen it. Beautiful out here, man. It's probably a little after, about 9:30 in the morning. Yesterday was awesome. Y'all saw a little bit of the footage from the geocacher. Y'all knew that we went geocaching yesterday for the first time. Both her daughter and son, Kate and Coda, absolutely loved it. And shortly after that night we went armadillo hunting with Copper and the kids and Biddy, and we had some fun, man. After that, we got in the truck and drove down some of the roads around here, see if we can catch and find us some armadillos. And we end up finding 2 armadillos, a dead possum, and a skunk, which, by the way, we did not pick up. Excuse me, I'm trying to get over these branches and clip these briars. And, we had a fun time. Kids had fun, I had fun, so it was awesomeness. Right now, I'm pretty much doing the walk that we did yesterday. With Copper, looking for armadillos. Show y'all something. Well, this is part of Scipio Creek, which is on both sides of my good friend's property. It's beautiful out here, guys. Absolutely beautiful. I'm just taking a little morning walk, and tomorrow I'll probably take you on a walk, camo style, baby. Tomorrow's my last day, and we're gonna have some fun, and today and tomorrow we're gonna have even more fun. This has been a great vacation. Biddy, I truly appreciate this. You, Rick, Coda, Kate,
and Brittany, Dee, Bob, your parents, Rick's parents, your side of the family, his side of the family, I really, truly appreciate this. You don't know how much it feels, how good it feels to know that there are people that out there that care about you, even when they don't even know you. I love you guys for that. And I truly appreciate that. This will probably be the one and only time you'll ever see Camo crying on camera. All right, man. Let's get it. See y'all in a bit.
I'm trying to help.
Oh, I see that.
Just in case y'all want to know, she's not talking about nobody. But if you want to volunteer yourself for that, then go ahead. That looks really good. I like that. Very cool. What's up, guys? Y'all know who it is, man. I gotta keep telling y'all. So today's the last day. Sunday. Beautiful day. Weather's a whole lot more wonderful than it was when I first got here Wednesday night or early Thursday morning. It's a beautiful day, guys. Let me show you. Got a little bit of wind, but still a beautiful day, man. So probably gonna, what's gonna happen today is probably we'll head out once everybody's up and running here in a couple hours, and head out to grab something to eat together just once, as one right before they head me out and take me back to the airport today. My flight leaves out today at 7, so I tell you guys, I've had an absolutely awesome weekend, man. This is a great place. There's good people that live here in Oklahoma, man. It's, all I can say is I wasn't aware that there were places like this ever, you know, left in the world where people care about people, and that's the end of the sentence. There's no ifs, buts, maybes, accordings, if, you know, none of that stuff. So I'm just doing my rounds, guys, kind of show y'all, you know, all the fun stuff that's going on. Saying goodbye to all the chickens there. Y'all saw him earlier say goodbye to Turk. Hey, Turk. There's my boy Blue. Hey, Blue. Y'all might not be able to see Copper way out there. He out there on the scent of something. He might just be out there getting ready to take a poop. But last night was pretty cool, man. See if I can go show it to you. Biddy always told me about how they have possums and stuff out here, and since they've had Copper, Copper's a hound dog, so Copper will hunt down a possum in a minute and tree it. And then once they tree it, then Rick comes out, the 22, and pops him. Now, possums are a bad thing out here because it kills the chickens. So anytime they get a chance to kill a possum out here, they do it, and I completely understand. You know, you don't want other animals taking food out of your mouth. But last night, we were inside, and Copper just went to baying. That's the other new thing that I heard, too. I heard a couple, but hey, Luke, what's up, buddy? See my friend. My friend came to follow me. That's a good boy, bro. That's a good boy, bro. Copper went to bellowing like he found something. So we came out here, and Copper was around this tree just barking his head off. Woo! I don't sound like a dog. I know, Blue, that's not me. Sorry, buddy. And actually what happened, I don't know if y'all can see it, but up there is no longer there anymore. So either he fell out the tree and another animal probably took him off. There was a possum. And Rick popped him pretty good a couple times. I think once in the body and once the last one was in the head. And I think he was pretty much caught up in that tree. He wasn't coming down, but he was dead. So either he fell out last night or, either he fell out and the dog took him away or some other animal picked him up and took him away, but he was definitely dead. So, one more thing else, y'all. For all y'all guys that know who Bitty Boo is, y'all also know a little bit about the history of how Bitty got her name. Her YouTube name. If you don't know, I'm going to tell you a very small portion of the story here. Very, very small portion of the story that I know. Bitty loves pugs, in addition to all other critters. She had a pug affectionately named Bitty Boo. And she has another pug now that is called Fat Fat. Fat Fat and Bitty Boo were mated pairs. Well, Bitty Boo passed away, and I would believe that Bitty loved her so much that she named her channel name after her pug. And right here, I don't know if I can show you guys, you see the memorial right there. This is where Bitty Boo forever lies. And all the hearts of all those that loved her. So just a little story, a little background, and I know some of y'all guys know that story. Interested in knowing that little piece of information. So, but yeah, guys, it's windy out here this morning. Warmer out here today. It's been getting warmer every day. I would call it 60s today. But yeah, guys, there's the ponds out there. I didn't get a chance to go fishing this weekend, but I'll be back. My family lives out here. And all you folks out there that know what family really means, not just because somebody happens to be born with you, they happen to be called your brother and your sister, or they happen to be called your mother and your father, doesn't make people family. And if you don't agree with me on that, well, that's your failure of understanding. But anyway, my family lives out here, and I want to visit my family as much as possible. Just want to, real quick, again, I want to thank Bitty. I want to thank Rick. I want to thank my little buddy Kate, Coda, Brittany, for that fantastic meal you cooked Saturday night, Brittany. Very good. Very delicious. If you didn't think I liked it, then I don't know what you think three helpings of that was. That was good. Bub, D, all y'all guys, man. It's just Rick's side of the family, Biddy's side of the family. You know, thank y'all. Really, really, truly appreciate it. Y'all guys didn't have to welcome me. Y'all did. And that's what's important, man. Thank y'all guys very much. I love all y'all. And I'm pretty sure I'm welcome to come back anytime. Biddy's already told me that. There's no invitation needed. That's what family's supposed to do, right? Hope y'all guys had fun. I know the hell I did. And with that said, when you see me on the homestead, don't yell. Don't bail. It's just your boy, Camomeleon and Biddy Boo Brown. Thank y'all.
Without conviction.
Now, y'all didn't actually think I was going to end the video on myself, did you? Y'all know who this lady is in front of you. Everybody loves Biddy. Biddy, I've been telling everybody how much of a fantastic job I had. I mean, a fantastic time I've had this weekend. I just, you know, how much everybody has just, you know, been so nice and so welcoming. How has the weekend been this weekend for you?
Oh, my God. It's been awesome. I'm probably going to bawl my eyes out, though, because I got to take you back to the airport today. But it's just like one of my kids I hadn't seen in a long time has just come home. And it's awesome. I have thoroughly, thoroughly enjoyed it.
It's, you know, it's so sad. We were talking about it that prior to me coming, the day before were the longest hours in the freaking world.
Oh my God. It seemed like every hour that passed, it took 6 hours to get that 1 hour out of the way.
That's right. But the moment that I got off the plane, it seems like for every hour, it's 6 hours would be already gone.
I know.
They went fast.
Very fast.
Got a visitor.
Hey, Turk, Turk. Hey, Turk, Turk. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead, Turk, Turk. It seems a lot of the stuff that you told me about, I actually got to experience. Like last night, Copper caught a possum. Tell everybody about that last night.
Well, him and his poor little pitiful bay. I was hoping Camo would get to hear this poor dog bay before he left, and finally he did. Copper treated possum, well, ran a possum up a tree,
mm-hmm.
And then Rick had to go out there and shoot the possum to where it wouldn't get my chickens. But that ain't all you've got to see.
No, it's not.
You've actually got to see a real live armadillo.
Yes.
A skunk.
I did.
And a possum. We haven't come across any deer, though.
No deer. And you would have thought that maybe in walking in the woods or something, we'd have seen them out in the fields or something. But I don't know if, is it deer season now? Or
yeah.
It is?
It's rifle season, so they're probably hit out.
Yeah.
you did get to see that my turkey thinks he's a dog.
Yes. That big white bird that y'all saw a second ago in between me and Biddy, that was a turkey. That's turkey. That's what I've been telling y'all about. Ain't scared of not many things, apparently.
You got to see the horses.
Yep. Buddy.
Yeah, Buddy. The calf.
I actually got to pet Buddy this morning.
Did he let you pet him?
Yeah, because I walked up to the gate, and he was in the back part, and he just started walking up towards the gate. And I was like, okay. And he put his head there, and I just kind of reached over and pet him a little bit, and then he pulled his head back a little bit and came forward. So I don't think he's scared.
No, he's not. He's trying to make it hard for me to butcher him.
He's doing a fantastic job.
I know. It's getting harder and harder every day. I mean every day. Because I don't... And I can't just have a steer sitting here eating. Because I can't afford that.
Right.
But stinking on it, I don't think I'm going to be able to butcher him either. So I'll probably just have to sell him. And that'll kill me too. So.
Yeah, well, you have options. You don't have to...
I know.
You can take the less... deliberate route, but it's still going to be just as bad.
Either way, he will end up being processed if I sell him because he's a steer. If I keep him, he's going to have to be processed because I can't just continue to afford to just feed him.
Yeah.
And then I look at it, all the money I've been out feeding him to get him fat, why should I let somebody else have him?
Right.
But then I don't know if, when it comes to time to cooking him up, I'll actually be able to sit and eat him. So, yeah. I'm in a big dilemma.
Now, you got to do geocaching this weekend, too.
Yes, I had never geocached before. It was more fun just watching my kids. Oh, my God. And Dakota finding his on his own. That was so funny.
That smile.
That boy smiled from ear to ear.
Yep.
And Kate, Well, everybody's seen Kate, how excited she gets.
Yeah, so. Well, Kate's just naturally excited. That's a wonderful child. She really is. If you're having a bad day, Kate will just force you to just have a smile on your face. She is just one of those little kids. So now Kate is ready for, She does not call it geocaching because it's apparently not the correct term.
Yeah.
So what does she now call it, Biddy?
We go cashewing.
Cashewing. You heard that, Jeep? It's now called cashewing.
She asked me, can we go cashewing?
So are you going to, so what's the plan with that now?
Well, now that, the kids are being homeschooled. I think so. On some of their field trips, is going to be doing the geocaching because it will help teach them coordinates. So that can kind of integrate into some lessons. So.
Very good idea. Very good idea. Hey, guys, y'all have no idea. It has been. There's been so much done this weekend. I can't even remember. I mean, it's a lot of this I will remember, but it's been just... I can't tell you the last time I've actually gone out of town and actually had this much fun. I mean, I could have come here and sat, and we could have did this the entire weekend, just sat here and just bullshitted for 4 days, and it would have been the best trip ever. But the fact that we were able to do little small stuff here and there just added to it. I mean, this trip was 200% by the time I get back on the plane.
Well, you got the first night, you got up. Well, no, the first night you ended up eating Taco Bell because we got home so late.
Yep.
The second day we had Thanksgiving.
Oh, I'm so full.
And then the next we had deer meat.
Yep.
You got to eat chocolate gravy for the first time.
Chocolate gravy? Y'all don't know what chocolate gravy is? Y'all missing out. Oh my God, that's so good. Well, the first, all right, so after Thanksgiving, what did we have for dinner? So tell them that if they hadn't, so the deer meat.
Oh, deer meat, mashed potatoes, gravy, chili beans, cornbread.
By the way, all homemade.
I don't remember.
That was it.
Yeah. That I forgot to make the apple pie still.
Still forgot to make the apple pie.
I'm sorry.
Oh. You know what? That's just going to destroy my trip. You know what? This trip was absolutely a failure. I just don't even want to be here anymore. So, was it last night? It was last night that Brittany made the...
chicken casserole. Oh, my God, that child can cook a chicken casserole.
She can cook it. Guys, if you didn't think I didn't like it, and I said this earlier to Britt on video, I had three helpings. If you don't call that like, I don't know what you call it. That was... good. Oh my God, that was good. Rick can cook.
Yeah, she can.
She can cook. If she keeps doing this, I told Rick, I said, Rick, you're a lucky fella. You got a house full of people that know how to cook. I said, buddy, you should be big as this freaking outside here.
And let's see. You got to be in on one of our family traditions, even though it took a day later than normal.
Yep. Yep. Y'all saw a little bit of video of that. So, just to give y'all a quick story, it's, you know, due to my past and certain things with family and stuff like that, it's been 7 years since I've actually had an opportunity to celebrate Christmas, letting them put up a Christmas tree, letting them be involved in Thanksgiving-type traditions and stuff like that. So, yesterday was the first time in 7 years I've actually sat down and set up a Christmas tree and actually truly enjoy doing it. And to do it with, you know, with, not just put it up yourself, because you're the only one putting it up, but to put it up with everybody else. I got to put up the what, well, you tell it, Biddy. I mean, you do a better job telling it than I do.
Well, I made you do the string and the lights. I hate that.
Yep.
And we fluffed out the tree. We strung, you strung the lights. We had to make hangers for some of the ornaments because I forgot to buy any.
Mm-hmm.
But we, I mean, it's just, the others bailed on us though. Kate's the only one that stayed with us. Because the others, they was too busy watching a movie to do the family tradition.
Yeah.
So, now Rick, Kemo, and I were both too short to reach to put the star on the tree.
That's right. I'm not the only short one that can't do that.